हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टुडे इज यूनिट 4.1 एंड इन द लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द बोल्शेविक एंड द रिवोल्ट ऑफ प्रोविंशियल गवर्नमेंट दैट वाज द अक्टूबर रेवोल्यूशन 1917 एंड आफ्टर द अक्टूबर रेवोल्यूशन. Now, what was there? There was the condition of a civil war in the Russia. What kind of condition was there? Civil war in the Russia. What is civil war? Civil war means when the citizens of the country, they are fighting among themselves. When there are intense fight within the country among the citizens, that is known as the civil war. Right. So what was there in the civil war? As we have already read in the last unit, that what was there, that Bolsheviks, they were socialist. But what happened? They were socialist. They were implementing their ideas, their attitudes now change. The attitude of the Bolsheviks now changed. Earlier they were in the favor of people, now they were imposing censorship and many other harsh steps they were taking. So what happened when the Bolshevik ordered land redistribution? The Russian army began to break up. What was there? As you know, in the April thesis of the Lenin, what was there? That Bolsheviks ordered the redistribution of land. Then what happened? Due to this, the Russian army began to break up. How? Due to the land redistribution, the Russian army began to break up. That time army was under the control of Bolshevik party, military revolutionary commission, remember, or order committee, right? When Bolsheviks ordered land redistribution, the Russian army began to break up. Means what they were doing, they were leaving the army and they were saying that if we will go in army, then who will take care for our family? Then our family will not get the land. So they were leaving the army. Soldiers, mostly peasant, wished to go home for the redistribution and deserted. What they were saying, that they wanted the land of nobles, non-Bolshevik socialist. Other communities were also there. You know what was there? Bolshevik control was good in the town areas. In the town areas, mainly in Moscow and Petrograd. Mainly in Moscow and the Petrograd. But where there is old regime, old Tsarist regime, then what was there? Their non-Bolshevik socialist, liberals and supporters of autocracy condemned the Bolshevik uprising. Means they were planning to curb the uprising of the Bolshevik. They were not in favor of the Bolshevik. Non-Bolshevik socialist means Bolsheviks were socialist. Here some people were there, those who were not in the favor of Bolshevik, but they were socialist. Non-Bolshevik socialist, liberal, supporter and of autocracy. Supporter of autocracy means the aristocrat class or the conservative class, those who were there after the Tsar. Means they want the Tsar rule again. Their leaders moved to South Russia and organized troops to fight the Bolsheviks. The Bolsheviks were considered with red color. What they did, the liberals, socialist, and these liberals and the non-Bolshevik, they were considered with green. They were recognized with green, and the aristocrat class or the pro-Tsarist, they were considered with white. During 1918 and 1919, the Greens revolutionaries, Greens means socialist revolutionary and white means pro-Tsarist, controlled most of the Russian Empire. What was there? Petrograd and Moscow was under the control of Bolshevik, but most of the Russian Empire was under the control of socialist revolutionaries and who was there? The white pro-Tsarist. So what they did? They merged with each other and they controlled most of the Russian Empire. And what they did? They organized troops to fight against the Reds. They were backed by France, means France, American, British and Japanese troop helped them. How they helped them? Because it was civil war. सिविल वॉर मीन्स विद इन द कंट्री, हाउ द अदर कंट्रीज, हाउ द कंट्रीज ऑफ आउटसाइड हेल्प दीज पीपल, द ग्रीन्स एंड द वाइट्स. दे वर नॉट डायरेक्टली पार्टिसिपेटिंग बट दे वर इनडायरेक्टली helping in the help of in this in the form of money or weapons to the whites and greens. All those forces who were worried why they were helping to the white and green, they wanted that socialism will not spread. They want that socialism will not spread in the other part of the Europe, so that's why they want to curb this socialism ideology. That's why they were helping the mainly whites. As these troops and the Bolshevik fought a civil war, looting, banditry and famine became common. Banditry means ban and all. Looting became common. So what was there? Famine became common, and supporters of the private property. What was there? Supporters of private property, whites, took harsh step with the peasants who seized their land. What happened? Now whites, what they were doing? Because they belongs to the rich class, what they were doing, they were taking the harsh step against the peasants who controlled the land of the nobles. Now what the peasants think that whites are against us, so they started supporting the Bolshevik party. Such action lead to the loss of popular support of the non-Bolshevik, like whites and reds. By January 1920, the Bolshevik controlled most of the former Russian Empire. Now, what was the Bolsheviks were in power? So, what they did? They were successful in curbing the revolt of the whites and greens. And now, whose control was there on the complete Russian Empire? Bolsheviks. They succeeded because the military was under the control of Bolsheviks only. Military was under the control of Bolsheviks. To cooperate with non-Russian nationalists, Muslims, Jihadists, cooperation did not work. Here, Russian colonies themselves turned into Bolsheviks. In Kiva, in Central Asia, Bolshevik colonists brutally massacred local nationalists in the name of defending socialism. What in the Kiva, Central Asia area is there, an area is there, Bolshevik colonies. That was the colony of Bolshevik. What the Bolsheviks did, they killed the nationalist people on the name of defending socialism, that they are defending socialism. In this situation, what were their people were confused. They have to support the Bolshevik or not. Why they were confused? Because sometime it was looking that Bolshevik is working for the people, and sometime it was looking that it is against the people. So people were confused. Partly to remedy this, most non-Russian nationalists were given political autonomy in the Soviet Union, that is USSR. USSR means United Soviet Socialist Republic. The Bolshevik created from Russian Empire in December 1920. When was the USSR formed? You have to tell me. But since this was combined with unpopular policies that the Bolshevik forced the local government to follow, like harsh discouragement of nomadism, attempt to win over different nationalists were partly successful. Means they were forcefully compelling the people to accept the things. Means nomadism is life of those who do not live in one place but move from one area to another area for their living. Right, this was there of the civil war. Next thing is making a socialist society. This we'll discuss in the next video. What is there in the this is unit 4.2, and soon we'll complete our chapter. Till then, revise the question, revise the chapter, and make the questions thoroughly. And you have to learn this chapter till unit 4.1. Right. Thank you.